Hey folks, cheers from down under,
Australia,
the Yarra River. But you knew that, right? You can hear those birds in the background. Those birds have weight and mass. That means they're hardware.
Ooh.
But are they simple hardware or complex hardware? Ah, those birds, yeah, they have a mind of their own. It's like they're programmed. If it has logic, it's complex. Yeah. Now, hardware. You all know about DO-254, otherwise known as ED-80 in Europe. It's old. It's almost as old as me. Not that old. However, it's been around for, wow, published 25 years ago and sat on the sidelines for 5 years until we sorted it out here in the USA with AC-2152, then Europe. Yeah. Well, folks, hardware. Think about it. You have a simple resistor. You can fully test it. V equals IR. It's simple. What is simple hardware? Well, hardware that you can fully test for all foreseeable operating conditions. Think about that. V equals IR, the resistance, the tolerance. What's the maximum current, maximum voltage, minimum, maximum temperature? Ooh, that's what you can do. You build requirements for that. You fully test, ooh, 8-bit, A to D converter. You can fully test it. 2 to the 8th, 256 test cases. That's what you've got. Now, software is always complex. It is. You can always have a pointer error. You need a process. Since you cannot fully test something that's complex, it has an infinite number of test cases, you have to instead, have a development process. That's called a development assurance process. Yeah. See those oarsmen out there stroking? They've got a process. They have a plan. They've synchronized. You need that for software because you cannot fully test, not an asynchronous system. Yeah, you can't. There's interrupts. Virtually infinite number of combinations. But hardware can be simple. But what's the definition of simple? Well, class, we have the new interpretation of DO-254. Now, we're writing a new 254. It's going to be called 254A. Yeah, the next version, the second version. But we've reinterpreted it 4 additional times already. The latest interpretation is called AC-2152A, or in Europe, AMC-2152A. A is the key. Now, folks, for A, you need a little more rigor to prove something is simple. How many transfer functions? Is it programmable? Is it asynchronous? How many stages? We have to document that in an ECMP, Electronic Component Management Plan, ECMP. That tells how we source it, how we ensure that we synchronize, the requirements, the tests, the configuration. Now class, COTS hardware. We don't want you to use COTS software. Not really. Well, we got a new DO for that. Look for a future video on that one. But hardware, we want you to use COTS hardware. Even if it's old like me, it's reliable. Well, it is. It's consistent. We know what you're going to get. So now, if you do that, you can actually plan ahead. Yeah. Plan ahead and predict consistency. You can predict determinism. Think about that. If you introduce all new hardware with a development process, are you really creating more reliable hardware? Think about that. You're using 254. All of the objectives. Is it really more reliable? Well, probably not. In fact, if it has a history, the hardware vendor is motivated to ensure it's defect-free. Even if they did not use 254, it's got a history, a safety critical history. If you have that, then you can really ensure, yeah, that you have reliable hardware. But for software, it's a little different story. That hardware, you need a process. Even if you're a solo, lone warsman, a single component, you still need a process if you want to win down under. Cheers from AFuzion, DO-254. There you have it.